What's up, guys? Star Wars Real Talk here. Hop on a stream because I A, have the time, and B, heard the news about Kathleen Kennedy. And I figured I'd jump on this right away. So, the information just got out that Kathleen Kennedy is going to be working with Star Wars, with Disney, whatever you want to call it, for years to come. That's the quote. The quote was, she's going to be with us for years. Now, the whole Star Wars community is kind of freaking out. Everyone kind of thought that she was done. Everyone was kind of thinking, like, the evidence was there that she was not a good fit to be in charge. And it is incredibly shocking that this news has come out and that this is the reality that Star Wars fans are facing. Now, I know that a lot of people are being positive and being hopeful, but two Finns here. But I would say probably more people are not happy with this news. I'm not happy with this news. Honestly, there's... I don't feel like there's any reason for me to be positive. I mean, when you're in charge of the entire sequel trilogy, that's Star Wars is like the biggest titan when it comes to franchise movies. And when you're steering the ship for three, I'm talking Star Wars movies. You got OT, prequel, and sequel. That's, like, it's just huge. It's a massive deal. You can't just sweep three Star Wars movies under the rug. I'm just really surprised. Like, she might be really good at her job when it comes to crunching numbers or management, but not inserting herself into storylines, making decisions. So, I'm shocked. I don't even know what to do with the news. I literally just went on a live stream and started ranting. I don't know. I mean, Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are obviously doing a really good job, and they're holding it down pretty good. But I don't know. There must be behind-the-scenes stuff going on that we don't know about. Maybe she's killing it. Maybe she's a great person. Maybe she learned from her mistakes. Maybe she's... I'm sure that there were a lot of meetings that went on, and... I mean, hey, from a business standpoint, like... they've probably seen what's working and what's not working. They know that the Mandalorian is... was killing it. In terms of... you know, viewership and sales and everything. Everything Dave Filoni and Jon Favreau have been behind has been just crushing it. And I don't know if Kathleen Kennedy had any input in the animated series or Mandalorian. So, I should have turned that box off on the side for viewers and comments, because at this hour, it's like midnight where I'm at. I don't expect anybody to be in this stream. I didn't want to turn the mic on and get my editing software going. I just wanted to go live, talk about it. And then hopefully my input is out there for tomorrow morning when people wake up. Yeah, man. The only thing I can think of is that she's killing it. And... like... in terms of management or numbers or something, she must be just doing a good job. There must be something going on that we don't know about. There has to be some kind of justification for her keeping her job. And them saying for years to come. When they say years, that sounds like they're really confident in her leadership. So... must be more to it. By the way, I'm playing the Resistance because it's still triple XP, and I'm trying to level up my BB-8 because he's my only hero that is not gold. I mean, if you guys are watching this, drop in the comments, what do you think about Kathleen Kennedy? Do you think that she's doing fine? I mean, we're talking Star Wars here. I feel like we should not be thinking about it from a perspective of, is she doing okay? Is it bare minimum? It's just, to me, it's straight up unacceptable. Just that we're talking Star Wars, we're not talking... I can't even think of anything else, like... Star Wars is just on another level. And I'm not just saying that because I'm a Star Wars fan, I'm talking about it from, like, a franchise. From, like... Every single Star Wars movie that comes out is the movie of the year. It's always, like... Nothing even comes close. It's a big deal. I don't know, man, I'm not behind it. I don't have it in me anymore to be positive about her. I'm just fed up with her. It's just straight up, it's not acceptable. Like, you don't get grace when you mess up two, arguably three movies. You're messing with people's childhoods, you're messing with people's escapism, you're messing with people's hobbies. Something that they love and cherish. Should be treated with more respect. Yeah. Level 41, that's what I'm going for. Yeah, I streamed already today. This afternoon. I probably should have talked about this then, but I didn't know. So now I'm streaming live to literally nobody. Whatever, I mean, I just want to make content. At the end of the day, I'm just a Star Wars fan, and this channel is just a place for me to talk. And if people come back and watch us after I'm done streaming, then, I don't know. I'm happy that I gave you guys something good to listen to. Hope I'm not too tired. Hope my voice is doing okay. Done a lot of audio today. My voice is kind of fried. So I'm a little bit voice cracky. I'm just going to stream until I finish this game. I don't have to work tomorrow, but... I don't know why I'm justifying myself to literally nobody. Yeah. Stealing all the kills here. I mean, getting back to the subject... When you look at the fact that George Lucas... Father of Star Wars... Did not show up to the premiere of Episode 8 or 9. The red carpet rollout, the big reveal of Star Wars movies. He literally created Star Wars. He didn't go to the premiere of 8 or 9. What does that tell you, man? They blew it. They blew it with Mark Hamill. They blew it with legacy characters. Precious window of opportunity. When they were all alive at the same time. Yeah, I'm not really holding back. I'm just the floodgates are open. I mean, there's always the possibility that they're keeping Kathleen Kennedy around because she's. It's like the reason they don't fire a bad manager, because they've been around a long time. They know the ins and outs. It'd be more work to train somebody new. We consider all these bad reasons for not rehiring. I mean, we're talking Star Wars, so I'm hoping that isn't the case. But I'm just considering all the possibilities here. It's always so jarring when I kill a stormtrooper and I just hear an incredibly feminine scream of a woman. I'm like, oh shit, I didn't know. Hey, chill out. Those stormtroopers are supposed to have bad aim. Uh-oh. Oof, I got lucky. Yeah, it's... What else can I say? It's just shocking. It's shocking news. And I'm looking forward to seeing how the Star Wars community responds tomorrow morning. I've already seen a couple people make videos. A lot of the big Star Wars YouTubers hop on the news right away. And getting on a live stream is the fastest way I can do it. Because I don't have to edit at all. I just hit broadcast and YouTube does the rest. Oh, this part of the map is always a total shit show. I'm 2 levels away from getting my gold BB-8. It's a lot easier to get kills with BB-8 than BB-9, so... Level 40. One more level to go. Right before I started this stream, I hit 41 with my BB-9. This is literally my last character I need to gold. Oof, that was close. Hey, you know what? If I can hit gold with BB-8, this video might have a happy ending. And not just me bitching about Captain Kennedy. Something good might come out of this. But my team's kind of crushing it, so... I'm getting off... Wait, do I get off the point and not make points? Here they come. I'm going to ditch those guys and try and score some quick points here. That stormtrooper just rolled off the edge. Very cool. Oh shit, nope, bad idea. I'm not making any points. This is a bad call. Bad call, bad call. Where are they all? Oh, come on, really? I need one more level? Okay, well, whatever. I mean, I've made my point. Captain Kennedy is going to be with Lucasfilms and Disney for years to come. So, unless something crazy happens, something more drastic, she really screws up somehow. It's looking like this is going to be our reality. And as much as I think it is a travesty that she is... She's had the power that she has. Nothing we can do about it. We just have to roll with the punches and hope that it's fine. Hope that she still is in control, but gives like leadership and creative control to Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni, the Star Wars saviors, the people that should be in charge. As long as she like, if she can keep a management position and deal with everything that doesn't have to do with the story itself, do anything not story related, and it could be fine. She, you know what? She could run Star Wars forever. I don't care. Just don't mess with the story. That's all I ask. Just keep your bony fingers out of the story, and we'll be happy. Okay, thanks for tuning into my late night rant. I know nobody tuned into the stream, but I wasn't doing this for the stream. I was just doing this to put out the content quickly. So, thank you guys for tuning in. May the Force be with you. Follow me on Instagram, Star Wars Real Talk, and DM me if you want to join the High Council. May the Force be with you.